simu huyo.
Security wao wachewe alindo mwana ulikweza kugunya kulwani ime
angamanya ati chene jesi alukuza kukola kakuba necho mkeza kune nyomano umutu mga ambamu tiatile palu songe ono msugule rawe nasi gale nga wanzala pita kwa mebo langu kamu sapu kaundi ligo mbaliyo kamu wera mpelezi kabi imugani saa mkolo kujendi regulai angesina sendi mu wera mpelezi
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Certificate of appreciation for honoring my invitation to come to Uganda. I also add a kilo of the purest Arabic coffee from Bugis region. And you'll see receive even the bag for the theme of today. His Royal Majesty, King Wanga of Kudon, Kenya, it is a honor for you to have accepted my invitation. I also award to you a certificate of appreciation. And you receive the best coffee on Earth planet, and a symbol of today's symbol. I want to summarize. The rest you can now, my Prime Minister, because of time, I will grant you permission to give the rest of my Royal Highnesses these gifts as well as their coffee. Ati, ngana kukwala kumbu kwewa masarabuni. What do I do? Neti leba anakumani mkoro kasi. Kale, katana kulenya akakulu, enombe Prime Minister, sima sakulu ni vati atikeni ziloma nasa nchilobus. Who supporting this function? You have come in big numbers, and then on bar, I hand over the microphone to the Prime Minister to carry on with the function.
Thank you, Your Highness. Honorable Dr. Magola, take over.
Asali mwanyala mamasaba, mwanyala buga, uwe mamasaba, mwanyala mgari, jimi kono jujo shizana, ni awene o, kata kukwa gani la, mai, Honorable Minister of State for Skaramoja Affairs, the Honorable Florence Nambozo Wamala, Ukweza, Achesoko Masala, Ramaria Kuchesa, Anagani, the Honorable Minister of State for Tourism, Anagani Domijenumuku, Abitag the Mamu Fuze, the program Yajenerate. Bye, Honorable Minister.
Nasi mireyaya, mama saba mwenayo, mwenayo nabi, ni mufuji sepe, minister wa tourism mukchali na soka aganike, nese na sese ibache se kumanya na nabi.
Thank you so much, colleague minister, our chief guest today, Honorable Minister of State for Foreign Affairs, Honorable Mulimba, our celebrant for today, Your Royal Highness Nomukuka, and all the invited highnesses that are with you today, the entire cabinet and the leadership of Obaba Masaba and the people of Bukisu. Of course, I don't want to forget the political leadership, the area members of parliament from Bugisu and those from outside, but also my colleague, the Minister for Eldare, Parobogi Dudu. I'll be brief and we can talk about this another day. I am so glad to be here today, and I think I was the first to come here deliberately, so that I'm not told about what happens on this day. And I don't think I have missed anything. And I want to thank His Highness, the Omukuka, and his leadership, who approached us. We had a good discussion as the Minister of Tourism, Wildlife and Antiquities, to see how we forge a relationship, grow this bond together, and promote the culture of Bugisu beyond just the Bugisu, the Bamasaba community. And Your Highness, we are delighted that you're entrusting us with that assignment. And we will do it diligently. And I believe that the next function will be much better and much bigger than this. When I had my brother, Honorable Nambeshe, my elder, speaking up there, and of course, request put in by my colleague, Honorable Karim. Honorable Karim is the Shadow Minister of Tourism, so we work well together. Now, we have focused on tourism in the Bamasaba land, and I'll just speak to two things, probably.
when we are doing our campaigns for domestic tourism after COVID, the first domestic tourism campaign we had was in Bugisu here. And we are here for around 4 days with a group of over 500 people, influencers, media people. And I've been interacting with a couple of people in the tourism business, and I can assure you that this campaign had a great impact in this area. And we will not stop. Secondly, Honorable Nambeshe, just to show you that this government has actually chosen Mama Sawa land as one of the focuses for tourism development under the directive of His Excellency the President. As we speak now, the first regional zoo, I don't know if people understand what the zoos are, but the first regional zoo in the whole country, apart from the one that is in Entebbe, is being constructed right here in Imbalu. It is going to be on 60 acres. It is a project of 22 billion. We have committed 7 billion now, and the construction is ongoing, just here in the neighborhood. And a number of other projects. I am here with a bigger team from the Ministry of Tourism, and we are doing a proper assessment, and all the other agencies, to see how we make this event much better. We know there is inadequacy of facilities, and we can see what we need to do to turn around this area to better it, and I can assure you we'll do that. But Your Highness, one final request to the people of the Babasawa. And I want to thank His Highnesses for the speeches that they gave, especially those that have been to Uganda for the first time. And I think we should go ahead. You can imagine His Highness has been here for only a few days. And most of them are saying Uganda is so beautiful, it is the pearl of Africa, oh my God. And the beauty of Imbalu. And Your Highness, I don't know what you do to one of your sons from Masawa land, who now would appear elsewhere saying that no, this place is bad. That one would be bad for us. But that is what we are saying. So the most important thing is, yes, we'll partner with these institutions, but the responsibility of of receiving and creating hospitality around tourism is for you people as the local community. So I want to ask of you, please continue being welcoming, you know, treat the guests well, and then we see, because what I've seen today, I'm also going to witness the circumcision, God willing. I am already done for me, please, I'm not on the list for today. Yes, I am. This beautiful culture that has been here for so many years, only enjoyed by the Bamasaba. What we want to do as the tourism sector is now to take it to the rest of the world. The rest of the Ugandans, but the rest of the international community. And the moment we do that, you will start making money off your beautiful culture. And that's what we are discussing. We want to add the business component to culture going forward. So I want to ask you, please, work with us, politics aside, and we'll see how we benefit and deploy our people in this sector. With those few remarks, Your Highness, I wish to congratulate you upon joining the Forum for the African Kings and Leaders. And I want to make one last request as I leave, that if you entrusted me with your guests, His Highnesses from the different countries that are here, for 2 days, I can show them more of this beautiful country. So I want to put the request before you, and if they agree, sir, today we agree and we start the work so that they can tell more about the power of Africa, because what they have seen is not enough. Thank you so much. I wish you the best, and I wish the people of Bamasaba land all the best. Thank you.
Our guests of honor, your colleagues, I want to take this opportunity to recognize all protocol, but appreciate the honors that have been bestowed to our king by the King of the Kings of Africa. keni mano ama nye mtibitu liye paru waka sile kuyama na abi nenga na kuwa simba kweza mbuga imanya la kweza sese nina mozo iso ngeri minira yeso roko nenga na enaza kuu kwa lako mili mojini nga jesu na mefe la anivali ikana moja basa enasa nyuki ena abigula kuno kwa
A guest of honor, Honorable John Mulimba, the ministers, the members of parliament, His Highness Umukuka Weba Masaba, His Highnesses from everywhere in Africa, our local leaders, LOC 5 chairman, our Prime Minister, all the cultural leaders here present, both from out and from within, my fellow Bamasaba, it mrembe mrembe, mwana lakweza mubuga, Your Highness, in view of time, I will be very precise. First of all, I thank for broadening our hukuka by bringing all the cultural leaders from Africa. Let's clap for our umukuka. Umukuka, we congratulate you. We thank you for your resilience, and we are happy that you are now our leader. Guest of honor, I will be brief, as I say. All invited guests, I am Dominic Mafabi Jidudu, Minister of State for Elder Affairs, from Ministry of Gender, Labor and Social Development. We are the People's Ministry. All you cultural leaders are under us. We work with you. Today, I'm representing my senior minister, Honorable Amongi Betty Ongom, who is out on official duties. I'm also representing Honorable Peace Mutuzo, who is the Minister for Culture and Women Affairs. She's also out on health issues. Also in my party, I'm the National Chairman for Older Persons. I am therefore an elder, and I'm representing all the elders in Uganda. way you out clap for Jidudu. Two, also, as I said, I'm a minister for the elder affairs. I listened very carefully. My people say, if you want to ask, you must first thank. My younger brother Nabeshe asked, but he forgot to thank what our leaders have done for this country. And since he's my younger brother, this is the lesson I'm giving him. That you must thank and then you ask. But the points he brought up, they are real points. And definitely, as we thank His Excellency, these points are going to be highlighted. They are good for our party, they are good for Izia Masaba, they are good for all of us. Ladies and gentlemen, I am a Mugisu. I got circumcised in 1964. Today, I'm 50 years since I was circumcised. It's my golden jubilee since I was circumcised. Again, if I were you, I would clap for the Dudu. So, my government, to honor me, they have said, together with Umukuka today, we are going to launch and open the circumcision together. My ministry gave me a long speech, but I can see all of you are tired. What I can say, number one, that in Uganda, we also have our kings together. And it's now that Africa has come in, our Umukuka will work with all these kings and their organization and link them to the Forum for Africa. I have been impressed by all you kings, the way you dress, the way you talk, and the majesty you have. That shows Africa is moving. Africa is self-confident. Africa is independent. Our ancestors allowed these people to colonize us. But the good thing is, like our president says, we are so resilient. The people in South America were all finished. They are no longer any Red Indians. They are no longer Red Indians in America. They are not recognized, but our Africans were resilient and they survived all this. Our ministry is conscious of you cultural leaders and the progress you are making. Growth is a process. Growth doesn't happen in one day, but growth comes when you are focused. I can see the focus. And when I heard so many of you had come here, I saw we are taking ground and we are becoming a force in Africa. Before I finish, as I said, we must appreciate. I want to appreciate His Excellency for giving a hand to Umukuka to make sure this occasion takes place. I want to appreciate him for the peace, for the security we have in this country, and the infrastructure that is prevailing. And after appreciating him, I will highlight the issues that our brother Honorable Nabeshe brought up. We have listed them and we are taking them to him. I will also appreciate it will also be taken and it will be appreciated. The leader from Lamu, Dr. Lamu, we appreciate you We appreciate your resilience and we wish you well so that you live longer to be paid for the resilience. Finally, I must thank our members of parliament. They are doing a good job. They are representing you effectively and they attend every mkolo that we have. And I will also use this opportunity before this group of Ramasaba to congratulate Honorable Florence Nambozo to catch the eye of the appointing authority and for her to be appointed as the Minister for Karamoja. Let's clap for her.
Of course, Your Highness, My colleagues, ministers, members of parliament present, all cultural leaders here present, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I take this opportunity to welcome you on this occasion of Imbalu Cultural Festival launch. I want to thank His Royal Highness Jude Mike Mudoma, the Omukoka Winsor Ramasaba, for the invitation he accorded to me to bless this momentous occasion today. I greet you all, Ramasaba, the well wishers who are here to join this occasion. This day gives us a chance to remind ourselves of our heritage with a view to preserve and promote our culture. Today is the highlight of the Festival of Imbalu, and I thank all the youth who are here to be part of the event. Here in Uganda, the celebration carried out by Bagisu and mass circumcision of males is done. It's a big, this pivotal culture, although for some people it is entertainment. The official first day of circumcision season is on 1st August, although the official launch of the festival is today. It takes place every even year and is characterized by singing, drumming, dancing, beer parties, and happiness. I would have loved to preside over this auspicious occasion in person, but due to other unavoidable national engagements, I am delegated Honorable Mr. John, to present me at this function and deliver my message. Whenever I come here for such an occasion, I'm always filled with joy. And when I see the people happy, displaying their culture and African traditional treasures, this has always been the agenda and distinguished value of the NRM government, fighting and advocating for freedom and openness of African people. That they may be free to make their own decisions, pursue their interests, generally do what they want. The solution of cultural institutions in Uganda, Busoga, Toro, Nyoro, Teso, Acholi, Alor, Ramasaba, among others, was achieved under the leadership of the NRM government. This milestone should be safeguarded for the meaningful cultural development of the African values and boosting traditional practices. I continue to urge cultural leaders to audit our different cultures, norms and practices. Some are relevant today, while others are irrelevant in modern times, with no information from science. We have those practices which can be retained and modernized. Backward cultural practices like female genital mutilation, cattle rustling, early marriages, wife inheritance, etc. should be eliminated. On this occasion, I call upon parents to be strict and to inculcate morals and values into our children. Continue counseling, especially the youth on behavior, to embrace the hard work and guard against HIV/AIDS pandemic so that we save and uphold the younger generation. The NRM government supports culture and will continue to promote and embrace cultural values that do not interfere. interfere with the violation of people's human rights and communities. I also encourage you to use culture as an opportunity for one's involvement through rehabilitation of cultural sites, sale of cultural artifacts, and construction of cultural museums, which can bring in revenue in this nation through tourism. I encourage Mama Saba to join hands with government in the wealth creation campaign at household level. I also appeal to leaders at all levels to sensitize our people and assist them on the selection of profitable enterprises according to their land size. The government recommends that small land holding concentrate on growing coffee, fruits, rearing dairy cattle, keeping poultry for eggs, saloons, hotels, border border, and doing fish farming. Most of these enterprises are currently for other people in the
world.
Thank you.
mule munteko mule munteko hukanahuta hukababirabo hukanahuta hukababirabo kubantu bashinire seniye chamane uwe kumuholo kuno Wilson Wotira kiri sahurambira twerani nafi mwanyala nabi mwanyala kuhufuka mwanyala kuhufuka mwanyala kuhuesa lukosi bama saba kuchenda ni lukosi bama saba kulinibirifa kulinishirifa ari rechele sanga ne kutakuchenda nza huwa mwamajile muri kuhalao kwa vele ngoloni kwa shindide kwa halao ngoloni Baba lume auringa kuta kutano, kuta kukulabusa kumukolo, kukualesa bache ninga, imbalu yefe nefana. Kuta ama kuulamo, kuroba kwa ilile mo, kuta kuchenda lunde kukala, mganebi ya bere ngorobeta. Mwafunile mulai. Ngorobe baba na njirile, titimu tos, nganeta furile. Ila baba mwole na nitimu tita kutano, luna kuesha lero. Nito tesi ngana kume mrangi sino, kubala njirile, Kuba ekameti kenywe baba furire babelireho futa kukaba titimu tisesa ba inga bango wafunile musa litondo kukano kusimilwe kuba kwa kanile na abiga no kukati leho luna kuresha leo Norwecho inga na hula anga mini sawo soo kalicha anine anga achiano apula anjirile titimu inga bulitimu kukano mra anjiri suwe Ukana mukwa mrangirisi isimobene mulondere. Shukana mrangirisi sukuna ebasa amalachire Musa u baba anabatambe ni hunya kameza kunzirata. Wafuchirisile. Aringa kutandika ingolobe mumanyire muri Bududa ni yabere number 1. Nga yabere number 1 ukana baduda mukuru wanjere mrangirisi wenywe Etano, kukone shina shio kumua. Itimu ye lile ho. Ok, arini mureche ele sebulai. Kulu huka na bara angiri sibeti timu timu. Itimu ya Mubutu. Inwela iye sonja. Tisimbi, tisimba. Inwela iye tinyimba. Kwaba ni timu ya Mubutu ya Kadodi. Kwaba ni timu ya Mududa Isonja. Kwaba ni timu ya Mombo Sinyimba. Kwaba ni timu ya Wakoko Isonja. Kwaba ni timu ya Wanale Isonja. Kwaba ni timu ya Mwambu. Nito teso kuluku kana kutitano. Bara njisi bene bali kwena beso kuluku kadano. Bara njini sibo njini mkweta kwa mungu kundicha Bara njini si, bara njini si, uwewe chibu shiri Halo Baduda mlikwena Wenye umranjisi wenye Kutahumuwa shina mo shenye Shetimu ya nyo hile Shesini njitimitu aloka makumimu sangu Mwanyala, mwanyala baduda, mwanyala, mwanyala Kuhula atakamunya kuu Mimi sawa kali chani yoro kwa ambisa umarangiri siwe nyo eno Itimu ye habili Itimu ye habili Nye mumbo Ali eno umarangiri siwa mumbo Uwe tinyimba Oyinyo mranjirisi wa mumbo eti nyimba Inga kwa mwele basa anolisa Itimu ya mumbo eti nyimba Jimutu waluka makumikarano ya mire timu ya kabiri Mwanyala mwanyala nabi Itimu ya hataru Itimu ya hataru mubutu
Itimu ya kataru mbutu tinyimba. Itimu ya kataru wana wetili numwana mwamubone. Nye babele ba kataru be tinyimba. Wabele timitu waloka makumi kataru.
Thank you. Mario.
Raja, I'm going to go to the hospital.
Imbalu Day Mutoto.